I heard of Olin. My grandma works at a bookstore, and she clipped out a newspaper article. She reads a lot. She clipped out a newspaper article and handed it to me. It wasn't about Olin. The article about Olin was on the opposite side. So I'm reading this nice article my grandma gave me, and flip it around, and boom, there it is. My first glimpse of Olin. I read it, you know, I got interested. It was pitched as a place where entrepreneurship and engineering came together as one. You know, I really liked that, so I was curious about it.
It's a situation where you want to meet everyone here and learn about them and what they have to offer or why they were admitted, because everyone was admitted because they are interesting people.
I founded a company in ninth grade of high school.
I really love martial arts. That's my thing.
I really want to do the Boston Marathon before I graduate.
I'm very into dancing. I have been since I was 2. I've done Indian dancing most of my life. Until recently, I got here and started taking belly dancing from my physics professor.
This kid Layton, he's probably gonna be a millionaire by the time he leaves here. There's this guy Brett, sometimes I want to call him Sergeant Brett because he's up and running and lifting weights and all this other stuff.
I am really passionate about rock climbing.
So just recently I was a contestant on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
A, acetic acid, final answer.
She did good by you, you have $25,000, Brett!
I can't think of a group of Olin students who I would not want to go on a road trip with, or be stuck somewhere on a desert island with, or be spending a night in an airport with.
You develop lifelong friends. Anywhere at Olin, I'd feel comfortable calling up and saying, hey, I'm going to be in town for a little while. You want to meet for dinner or something like that. It's that type of community. That's one of the best things about being here.
The greatest thing about Olin is the amazing faculty. That was my biggest attraction from the beginning.
The faculty are just wonderful. They're awesome. And they're not just, you know, really credentialed and really clever and everything, but they're really cool and nice and fun, you know, and they're so approachable. They're late going home for dinner because they're, you know, helping us figure out our project, or, you know, helping us cut some pieces for our design project. They're human beings too. They're really great people.
And the faculty are really out there to care for you and nurture you, as well as challenge you and help and make you grow.
I know a lot of the students here make a lot of extra work for themselves by taking on extra projects that have to do with the school and participating in clubs and things like that. So it makes it seem like the workload is really high, but I think overall people really enjoy that.
Olin coursework, a lot of the times, can be sink or swim, and your professors will just toss you in neck deep and see if you can keep from drowning, and I think it's a lot of fun.
One of the key points of Olin is their willingness to let their students explore by themselves, not necessarily in a rigid structure, but if you want to learn about something particular, you can. Currently I'm doing an independent study in bio-nanotechnology, which is a very specific class. It's great, it's just like a regular class, but it's personalized.
Some of the risks about Olin are actually almost perfectly in line with the advantages. While you know the curriculum is supported by some of the best faculty in the nation, there is the chance that you'll be taking a class that's never been taught before, and some of the things that you do here may end up not working out as well as you thought. But that's part of the thrill too. And that's part of what's kind of exciting about going to Olin, is that you never quite know what you're going to get, and when you put in some work and some effort, and at the end, you see something, and usually it ends up pretty good.
It's not so much about the destination as the journey, and I feel like that's a lot of what Olin's really about.
Every year Olin's around, it gets less and less risky to come to, because everything just keeps on getting better and better. You know, it was a great place when I came here, and it's even a better place now.
Although life is definitely very busy with academics here at Olin, I've definitely found time for athletics. There's a large constituency of runners at Olin that are always willing to go out. You just have to fight the snow most of the time, but there's beautiful trails all around Olin College that are wonderful to run on. They're great.
We play Ultimate Frisbee down in the field, kind of as an intramural sport. And you'd be surprised about what some Olin kids can dish out.
Like, a lot of Olin people go over to Babson and use the facilities there, especially the weight room, so that's as much of a social activity as it is for exercise.
Babson's got a pretty good intramural program, so there's, you know, there's soccer, there's basketball, it's even dodgeball. If you want to play sports, there's sports to play. You know, it's not intercollegiate, you're not going to be playing in March Madness, but you know, if you want to stay active, there's definitely a huge community here that's really focused on being in shape and being healthy, and that's great.
The fact that everyone is so diverse and so multifaceted means that you always have something to look forward to in just going through the halls and meeting new people and introducing yourself to people you don't know yet.
Olin's small size is really a mixed blessing.
It's maybe not the true college experience. You are building this college up from the ground up. You don't do that in most of your schools. You spend a lot of time working with Olin and developing Olin. Also, you know, you don't have your Greek life or the other things that come with a normal university or college. You're also building a school from the ground up. You know, most people who come to Olin think that's pretty cool. And they realize they have this responsibility to do that.
And because we're such a diverse community, albeit a small one, you're bound to find someone else here who has really similar passions to yours.
The people at Olin are actually pretty fun. It took a while to get started, but finally there's a little bit of a party culture at Olin. And it's nice because, you know, if you don't want to, can totally be not a part of that. Or if you want to, it's absolutely there for you. So, you know, the weekends are usually pretty decent around here. Or, if they're not, you can always go into Boston.
I probably get off campus about once a week. Ever since the beginning of my junior year, I really started to explore Boston a lot more, and it's actually a really exciting place, and I'm really glad that we're so close to Boston. It is sometimes a challenge to get there, but when you make the effort, it can really provide a lot for you. There's always the occasional trip to Fenway Park, which is priceless.
We're here in Boston, and it's a great city. I go into the city as often as I can, and there's so many different other schools here, and there's the Boston Symphony Orchestra. I've been to a few of their shows. I've been to the ballet. I've been to all these things that, you know, where I come from, we don't even have those. So it's pretty fun. It's a nice, good city experience.
You can go over to Babson if you want and take classes there in business. You can go over to Wellesley if you have a more of an art interest. You can go to Brandeis and take science classes. It's just great. You know, you have all these opportunities at your fingertips.
The support that Olin offers in terms of entrepreneurship is fantastic. It's a great resource to have the Babson students right next door, because there's a lot of kids over there that can write a pretty good business plan. There's a lot of room for collaboration between engineers and business students, and they can kind of, in any venture, take on the opposing roles that are kind of key to making something work.
I guess I feel like engineering is something that doesn't limit me as much as most people think. That I could go into law, I could go into medicine, that I don't necessarily have to be doing engineering the rest of my life. It's just a way of thinking that we're learning here more than anything else.
I wasn't sure I wanted to be an engineer, and now I'm actually pretty sure I don't want to be an engineer. But I found that that's okay, actually, because Olin tries to facilitate that. It tries to make someone who has a strong engineering background, but enough skill in other areas, arts and humanities, social sciences, that they can make that sort of transition. And so that's a risk that I was willing to take, and I'm glad that I took.
I was actually the only member from the class of 2007 to take the deferred year option, but I found it to be an amazing opportunity. I went to a very large university where it was about as different as could possibly be from Olin College. And it actually made me appreciate Olin a lot more for what it is.
You know, this is the place for you if you love engineering, if you like getting your hands dirty, if you like doing projects, if you like, you know, being in small classes and getting engaged, if you like, you know, having to be active in the community. You know, this isn't the type of place where you're just gonna kind of sit back and get on through it and get your degree. You have to be a part of it. You have to want it. But it's certainly not a place that's made for everybody. It doesn't pretend to be made for everybody. It's made for people that want to be entrepreneurial. It's made for people that want to be risk takers and engineers, and to really lead engineering in the next generation. And I think that's why this place was made, and that's why we're all here.
With enough people who have abilities and who have passion, I had confidence that an Olin engineer would be valued in the world.
There is one major experience that everyone basically has had before coming here, and that's being part of a family. And with all of its ups and all of its downs, that's really the closest way to approximate my relationship with everyone here. No group of friends at high school, no job, has ever prepared me for Olin more than just living with my mom, my dad, and my two sisters.
There's always someone who's sort of looking out for you, and people notice if something's wrong. And it's really great that Olin's atmosphere is close-knit enough that people know you well enough to see if you're, you know, how you respond when your mood changes. Like, people can just tell.
You cannot compare anything to the Olin experience. It's such a different type of school.
You know, when you're choosing between Olin and some of the top engineering schools in the country, and Olin's an unknown, and these schools have, you know, 100 years of reputation to back them up, some people have a hard time understanding why you might want to choose this unknown school. And I think if you're the right person for it, one of the most exciting parts is that it's unknown. It may be risky, it can also live up to your wildest expectations.
You know, to me, the biggest risk was not taking any risk at all. You know, deep down inside, I knew that if I didn't take the risk coming to Olin, I would never be happy with myself. I'd always be wondering what I would be like and what it would have been like to go to Olin.
Smell and the sound of waves crash down.